Jay Zadonik, and I wanted to take a few minutes to tell my story. I'm a very private person, so, you know, I don't really talk much, but I was convinced by one of the community members, you know, that everyone's story is important, so I just wanted to take a minute and share mine with everybody. I first started out, you know, with Torch, and it became, you know, the dividend became tradable into MMTLP, and I was very interested in it, and I kept adding to my position, and pretty much I started out with stock twits. I'm a very new to trading, so, you know, I was just reading about stock twits on there, and you know, then I found out more information on YouTube with like Tony and the Bird Lady, Terry, Uncle Smokey, and I kept learning, you know, how valuable, you know, this play was. So I continued putting money into it, and, you know, they pulled the U3 halt, you know, which really caused a lot of problems for me personally. But leading up to it, I actually had my son come to me, which he was 8 at the time, and he was like, "Dad, I see you're doing the stocks and things like that." So he's like, "Can you put all my money in?" So I put it in, and I decided to put it in on the MMTLP for him, you know, because I figured, hey, it's a, you know, no lose play. You could always fall back and have NextBridge shares. That was our safety net, you know. It just caused so much, you know, struggle and frustration for our family, you know, because I went heavy into this. We were supposed to move, and I put our house moving money in there. I put, you know, the little bit of capital I had on my business into there. Even my mom got into the play, you know, so that halt, you know, really halted, you know, our life. You know, over the past, maybe 2 months ago, I found out I need to have a knee surgery, you know, and the funds ain't there, and, you know, Christmas, you know, they took our Christmas away from us. We weren't able to travel like we wanted to, but it's okay. I actually spent New Year's, you know, on Twitter with the rest of the community. I didn't even know there was a community until early December, but I found them and I rung in New Year's, you know, listening in Twitter. So, but, you know, it just cost us so much. You know, I actually had to let 2 people who actually process items, you know, for my business. I'm a small business owner as well. I had to let them go. So it's like, when's this gonna end? You know, how many people have to suffer? It's not just me. It's not just everybody on the Twitter community. It's many people beyond that. And, you know, people getting cheated, fraud, just to, you know, protect their rich golf buddies. It's very unfair in the market. You know, and I went through the stages, you know, I went through being upset, being depressed, crying, I mean, all of it. And I just, you know, wanted to tell my story, and anybody else, if you're out there listening, you know, like I said, I'm a very private person. I hardly ever talk on the Twitter spaces, but, you know, your story is important, and it's part of history. What they did to us was very unfair. Hopefully we get our justice. That's the only way I could see this being resolved, is to give us the 2 days back. But yes, it's been a struggle, and the community is great. I actually had people in there reach out to me and offer to give me money and help out with things. You know, we had multiple expenses came up, but we just we just figured it out. You know, we don't like to lean on anybody. But it's just great knowing those type of people are out there who actually care. I'm a father. I have 2 young children. My son's 10 and my daughter's 6. And, you know, I just want to show them that, you know, it's not okay to be cheated. You know, we were cheated. It's not even cheated of the monetary thing. It's just cheated out of the ability to make and have these memories that we could, you know, give our children and have. You know, because in the end, that's all we really have is our memories. And I want everybody to know that getting involved in this play was a smart thing. I mean, there are times, you know, I regret it. And it's basically because of, you know, not having the money. You know, we needed the money to do things. My son was supposed to get his braces, and, you know, we had to put that on hold. I had to put my surgery on hold. And my wife had to put, you know, some of her procedures, you know, on hold too. She recently, you know, went through having a mass, and we didn't even know it was there. It ended up being like a softball-sized mass. And, yeah, we just been, you know, going through a lot of things. And, our grandma recently passed away, and, you know, we basically had to scrape, you know, just to go back up to Chicago. You know, it was a long drive. But, yeah, just a blue-collar family who saw the value in something. And, you know, we took our shot and swung for the moon. But, let me introduce you to my family.
Hi, my name is Heather Sedonic.
My name is Jake.
And we were all cheated. Hey, I just left for work actually, but I just wanted to add one final note is that during the run-up, we never sold. We actually bought more when it was over $10 because I had to do a phone order, and I closed out every single position I had in every single stock and went all in, you know, on MMTLP, and I just wanted to note that's how confident, you know, we were in that play. And you know, I hope we get our resolution soon. I love everybody in the community. It's a great community. I listen to it hours and hours a day. Fell asleep listening to it. Listen to it everywhere I go.